and it is was uneven, not like a sharp, it was uneven, okay friends, with a lot of up and downs. Okay, let's learn about the plains. The plains means the plains are level lands with gentle slopes. They are formed by the deposition silt by the great rivers. Means this the formation of the plains can depended on the deposition of the rivers, so by floods. So these plains are the level lands. Let's in the next topic we can learn about the deposition. Actually this deposition can it is the one of the part of the denudation process. Actually the deposition means when the force of the water and the river can slow down. So water has a great water and the wind has a great force to carry anything. On the time when the force of the water and the wind can slow down, on the time this totally the water and the wind can, it has don't have a force to carry the rocks anymore and any material. On the time it can easily dump into the rivers. So by that on the time when the material was dumped into the rivers, it can causes this totally this material can deposit to level the lands. So the plains are level lands with gentle slopes. They are formed by the deposition silt by the great rivers. Due to the great rivers, some of the great rivers can deposit this total silt and sand. So it causes to formation of the plains. Okay friends, tell me one example to the mountains. Yes, Himalaya mountains, and it is in the Nepal. And next one, tell me one example to the plateaus. Yes, Deccan Plateau and it is the largest plateau in our India. And next one, tell me one example for the plains. Yes, Indo-Gangetic Plains. Okay friends, let us recall second order of landforms. In any way result of the internal process of the earth, this is called as the second order of landforms. They are the mountains, plains and the plateaus. These mountains can form due to the erupting of the lava, and not only that, when the plates can pushed each other, lot of pressure can exerted from the mantle on the another plate. On that time what happening means one plate can goes under into the mantle and one another plate can goes to form a chains of the mountains. By that the formation of the mountains can occur. And by that, so, next one is plains, where the river is in the floods, it cuts the soil, and when it is not in flood, it deposits silt and thus the forms of the vast flood forms. Okay friends, I think you have understand about the formation of the second order of landforms. Let's learn about the formation of the third order of landforms. Not only that, the water and the moisture in the air also help this process to broken the rocks. And next one is, so by that not only water and the moisture in the air, some of the chemicals which can present on the water, it can also begins to break the rocks. Friends, are you understanding? So the process by which the rocks and are weakened and the broken are called weathering. And next one is erosion. Erosion means the active wearing away of the earth crust by the moving agents such as water and the wind. Friends, see here what happening means, after the weathering can takes place, the erosion will takes place. See here friends, the flow of the water and the wind, it has a great pressure to cut away the upper layer of the rock. Friends, are you understanding? The force of the wind and the water. It has a great pressure to cut the upper layer of the rock, and it can slowly wear out. Okay friends, are you understanding? So the active wearing away, so it can cutting the upper layer of the earth surface is called as erosion. The active wearing away of the earth surface of the moving agent such as water. So I think we already learned in the formation of the plains. Okay, deposition, when the force of the water and the wind can slow down, on the time what happening means this totally when the this was slow down, on the time they can dump into the water. So by the dumping, the river can it can causes to travel one place to another place by the transportation. So the river can reaches into the sea, and after the layer after layer accumulate and the deposit the transformed into the sedimentary rocks. By that, the denudation process it can occurs. And next one is, let's learn about the formation of the third order of landforms. For example, hills. These hills also formed due to the formation same closely interlinked the formation of the mountains and the plateaus. But the hills are not very high. Much of the mountains, it was it has the very steep slopes, and also it was small, it has not much higher than the mountains, so it called as the hills. Hello, I can't understanding, please tell me loud. Hello. Hello. Yes, friend.
Hello.
Hi, Swaru. What's your doubt? Where are you from?
My name is Tejasri. I'm from Vaira School.
Yes. What's your doubt?
My question is, what is called sea floor spreading? Can you explain it?
Sea floor spreading. Okay, friends.
Yes.
Okay, Swaru. I can explain about the sea floor spreading. Means it is. You has a wonderful question. Okay, that I can clarify your doubt. So,
okay.
due to the lava which was raising up, so on that time the ridges can formed. So it can see here. I think. Okay, friends, tell me one example for the delta. Hello, Swaru.
Hello.
Who are you?
Hello. What is the plate tectonics?
Okay, friends. A wonderful question. A plate tectonics means the movement of the plates is called as a plate tectonics. Due to the pressure from the mantle, on the time the plate this totally on the time what happening means it causes to it erupt. It causes to one plate can goes under into the mantle, while another plate of to goes upwards to form a chains of the mountains. Okay, so the formation of the valley and the sand dunes can takes place due to the work of the water. So the water has a great force to can do anything. See here, V-shaped valley, Grand Canyon, Plentiful, and the Mindus. Let us learn about that. V-shaped valley means the river. The work of the river can begin at the source. So in the especially in the high mountains, the flows of the river was very swift. Means it was very fast. And the by that it can descend to steep slopes. See here, friends. These are the steep slopes. So it has so by that it can exert due to the force of the water. It can exert a great force to cut the mountain vertically. By that the V-shaped valley can form. Okay. By that this the narrow at the bottom and the wider at the top. So that like that V-shaped valley can formed. Okay, friends. See here. So by the formation of the V-shaped valley, we can learn that water has a great force to cut the heavy and hard rocks. Hello. Hello, Swaru.
Hello, I am P. Surakiran Swaru. My question is, what is the
tell me. Hello, Swaru.
Yes, hello.
What's your doubt?
What is the meaning of tectonic plates?
Tectonic plates. I think I have explained about the tectonics. Means the movement of the plates is called as a Take notice. I think you have very clear understanding about the movement of the plates, so it was no need to introduction. So the technotics means the word, when we compare it to the Greek language, it is called as a tecton. It is means carpenter or the builder. And when it's related to Sanskrit language, it was called as the takshan. It means carpenters. So the movement of the plates is called as the plate tectonics. Friends, have you clear? Okay. And next one is Grand Canyon. Due to the force of the water, so Grand Canyon has a very deep stretching features which was seen on the deserts. See, first one is Mushroom Rock, and second one is Inselberg, and third one is Sand Dunes. See, this Mushroom Rock means is nothing but it has eroded, the head was eroded a lower section than the upper section. So on that time, what happening means it causes narrow at the bottom and also wider at the top. So due to the force of the wind only, the rock wall became look like the mushroom. It can call as a Mushroom Rock. And second one is Inselberg. Friends, are you understanding? The second one is Inselberg. Inselberg means the isolated residual hills which was abruptly raised from the underground. So it's called as a Inselberg. Hello Swaro.
I am from Lakshyapet school.
Tell me, what's your doubt? What's your name?
My name is Blessy.
What's your doubt?
What is the Pacific Ring of Fire?
What is the Pacific Ring of the Fire? Okay friends, this topic was actually not related to my topic, but I can explain that Pacific Ring of Fire means a lot of volcanoes and the earthquakes can occur around the Pacific Basin. Friends, are you Pacific Rim? So the scientists can observe that a lot of volcanoes and the earthquakes can occurring at the Pacific Rim. So it is called as the Pacific Ring of Fire. Okay friends, are you understood? Okay. And next one is work of waves. Due to this, work of waves can create the coastal landforms. Friends, have observed that this work of waves can create the coastal landforms, and this totally the coastal landforms can depended on the erosional process and the depositional process. See here, friends. The water has a great force to cut the rocks. We already learned that, but let's learn about the work of waves. So due to the force of the water, it continuously strike the rocks. For example, this, and the next one is the Stax. The Stax is nothing but like that only. The Stax can appear due to the erosional process, and like that only, when the force of the water can hit on the rocks again, but these cavities also, after the formation of the arch, these cavities also grow bigger and the bigger. So on that time, the totally the roof work collapses and the walls are left. It is called as the Stax. See here friends, these are the Stax. The sea cliff means the steepy rocks coast rising almost vertically along the rivers is called as the sea cliff. See here, this is the steep rocky coast at the coast. So it was almost vertically to the sea. So it is called as the sea cliff. So this sea cliff can form due to the pressure of the waves and due to the pressure of the water. By that we can learn that the water and the wind have a great force to cut anything, and it has can move heavy and hard rocks. Okay friends, work of glaciers. Slow moving mass of ice is called as the work of glaciers. So glaciers, through process called plucking, in which it lifts pieces of the rocks and transport them through plucking and the abrasion, glaciers create new shaped valley. And next one is I think you understand about the work of the glaciers. And next one is work of the water. And friends, I think you understand, the flow of the rivers is very swift, so it causes to the work of the water. So it called by that the U-shaped valley was formed. Okay friends, see here, I think you understand about this. These are the mountains and these are the plains, these are the plateaus, And see here, friends, this is the delta. The silt by the great rivers can covered at the here. So by the totally deposit here, it causes formation of the delta. And next one is this sea. Due to the seas, this also deposit the silt. So this is caused by the deposition process. So it causes to deposit it on the time the sea meanders. This totally the force of the water can cut a new path like gentle snake slopes. It's called has a meanders. Friends, have you observed? And see here, this is the related to second order of landform. These are the plains. These plains are it can cause due to the deposition of the floods. So by the great rivers, it can totally deposit here, and it was very level. And with so it was very leveling plains. It's called has some plains. And next one is the mountains. Mountains means, see here, friends. It can causes due to the movements of the plates and also volcano eruption. But the edge of the mountain is very sharp, and also the edge of the mountain is very sharp. See here, friends. The steeps it has a steep slopes. Okay, but this is the plateaus. The plateaus means it is also closely interlinked the formation of the mountains. It also plateaus, but this was the flatted region at the sharp of the plateau. Okay, friends, have you understood? Okay, and work of wind. Strong wind carries sand and soil which strike the hard rocks. These two act as the abrasive sandpaper and the hard rocks. The wind action creates and everything. Friends, listen here. The work of the wind and the force have to cut the mountain vertically and everything. Okay, friends, I think you understand my lesson very well. Okay. And friends, lastly, by concluding that our secretary sir RS Praveen Kumar IPS was creating a lot of providing a lot of programs, and not only that, which was needed to overcome the competitive society. So competitive world. So let them utilized and proud to be Swaros. Bye, Swaros.